Glad to have you back. Now, other lawmakers are now coming out to take a position on the matter. They've also taken a position on the call for external investigators to look into the matter.
The Gombe State Caucus of the House of Representatives has come out in support of Speaker Yakubu Dogara and the leadership of the House in the ongoing controversy involving allegations of budget padding in the House. In a press conference late on Thursday, the group accused the former chairman of the House Committee on Appropriation of blackmailing the leadership of the House with figures he actually suggested. The lawmakers also insist that there is no need for external investigators, as the matter is purely an internal affair.
We of the Gombe State Caucus of the House of Representatives wish to categorically and publicly declare that we are not part of any evil group trying to cause disaffection and instability in the House of Representatives. And we will in like manner disassociate ourselves from any conspiracy and attack against Speaker Yakubu Dogara and the entire leadership of the House. The world, particularly Nigerians, must be told that the figures being reeled out by Honorable Jibrin as his basis of blackmail against the leadership of the House was actually suggested by him. On this note, we call on Honorable Abdul Mumin Jibrin and every other person or group waging war against the peace and stability of the House of Representatives to shed their sword in the national interest and leave the House to pursue its business of making laws for the good governance of Nigeria. Thank you, signed Honorable Ali Isa JC, Honorable Aishatu Jibrin Duku, Honorable Stars Yunusa Ahmad Abubakar, Honorable Binta Bello, Honorable Ismaila Moazu, and Honorable Yaya Boshi Tongo.
This is an internal crisis. For goodness sake, Sarah calling for this thing to be investigated, external body to, and with my so-called transparency colleagues that are calling for an external investigation. It hasn't come to that. People have been deceived by the word that there is padding. Anybody that has padding is an act of illegality. It is like if now after Mr. President have signed the budget, then a member of Yakubu Dogara being the speaker came behind and insert something into the budget. So because when you continue using the word padding, that's what it signifies. Yet it called for public outcry. But then, like I explained, it's an internal process.
Another group of lawmakers also came out to take a stand. The Appropriation Committee of the House says there was no breach in the appropriation process to warrant any external investigation. Speaking to journalists during the briefing, the Deputy Chairman of the Appropriation Committee, Representative Chris Azubogu, explained that the former chairman of the committee, Representative Abdulmumin Jibrin, allotted all decisions of the committee to himself without conferring with its members. Despite their not being involved in the process, they are adamant that there is no truth in the allegations put forward by the former chairman.
This publication came up with essence of what is happening now. That matter was, I told you, the speaker said he will handle it his own way. At the point in time we were in a meeting, I myself was not aware that he had been removed. He called for a press conference and told her that he went to speak to the speaker that he has resigned. And he handed over information concerning the committee to me, so the phone was handed over to the new for the incoming chairman. And it was a press conference that was called in, and I just came in, I sat down, I listened to it. So why will I protest when he has already conferred with Mr. Speaker that he's going to resign? If you listen to the speech of Mr. Speaker, he made it very clear that the chairman approached him that morning and told him that he's tired of the job, he wants to resign, which is what he told me. So I pass information based on what it is. I didn't protest, and he's talking about misdeed. I was taking that. Yeah, if you're working with people, there's a disagreement. It wasn't meant for public. It was not meant for, it was a legislative process. So I want to make it very clear in media. We are all representatives from different constituencies, represent the interests of our constituents. If for any reason somebody makes a request for his constituency interest to be accommodated in a budget, that does not mean that the person is mutilating or padding a budget. It is right. So I want to assure you, there was no need to protest about his resignation because he communicated with the speaker, and that was that.
This case is just taking different turns and twists. But this is also raising a lot of questions. What exactly is budget padding? Was the budget padded or not? And what should be the next line of action to resolve this matter? And is it right to say that from all that has been revealed, that the House of Representatives has failed in its responsibility in the budgetary process? Now, these questions are some of the questions that are popping up, and we hope you can reach out to us. Let's have your own views on this matter. We also expect that some of the allegations that have been raised will be addressed during the week. You can be sure we will be bringing you all that and more here on the program. But this is where we will be calling it a day. Thanks for being there. Till next time, I'm Lanre Lasese. Take care.